tell you how closely I've kept the memories of you in my heart. And all of the lifetimes that we've had to share.
When our son John was born in 1980, he was our parents' first grandchild. Mom and Dad bought an air ticket so that Mom could come and be with us before and after his birth. Then a kind friend gave Dad a gift so that he could also come and see his new grandchild. They kept this a secret from me, and so I was totally surprised when Dad walked into the door of our apartment there in Taichung, Taiwan. I remember that Dad was really fascinated when he looked out the window of our apartment to the construction nearby where the bamboo scaffolding, and he also loved the various three-wheelers he saw. I guess this all tapped into his own deep DIY experience with construction and mechanics.
Now don't you be weary, 'cause waiting for you are wonders that you've never known. Just hold on to Jesus, reach out for his hand.
Hi, this is Dave. I'm the youngest son of Roland. I appreciated Dad's generous heart. He made others' interests his own interests. When I was in high school, I wanted to restore my first car. He even went out of his way to take classes in the evening on how to repair bodywork on cars. It was great that he could help me with that project. I'll miss you, Dad.
To listen to stories of saints new and old.
Hi. My name is April. I am the daughter of Wayne and Sherry. I mostly remember their old house and playing in the backyard and front yard and side yard. He would put on vinyl records for us to listen to, such as Alvin and the Chipmunks. He would also make us laugh with little jokes, and he would make pancakes in the shape of letters for our names. He would also, during the summer, he would set out sprinklers for us to play in and inner tubes for us to bounce around on. He was a really good patient when I wanted to play nurse. He enjoyed taking us to play putt-putt golf and also to get ice cream cones or other treats. He displayed acceptance and love to me through my entire life, and I will always love him and I'll miss him.
Hey everyone, it's Kyle James Hauser here, Steve Hauser's son. Grandpa was always so loving and supportive of me, especially in my music career, and would frequently send me words of encouragement. So I wanted to play a song that was written around the time that he would have been my age, and sort of says to me, sometimes you gotta go, and but it doesn't mean that we won't see each other again.
Times are getting hard, boys. Money's getting scarce. If times don't get no better, boys, I'm gonna leave this place. Take my true love by the hand, lead her through the town, saying goodbye to everyone, goodbye to everyone.
Cheryl Hauser, daughter-in-law of Roland. There are so many memories, but the one thing that I am the most thankful for is that our sons had a grandfather who was invested in their lives through his time with his faith in the Lord and a legacy that he left with them. They have unforgettable moments, and they have a legacy that will always live on. And so this daughter-in-law is so eternally grateful to you, Dad, and I will truly miss you.
Times are getting hard, boys. Money's getting scarce. If times don't get no better, boys, gonna leave this place. Take my true love by the hand. Town, saying goodbye to everyone, goodbye to everyone.
Memories around me. The sadness has found me. I'd do anything for more time. Never before has someone meant more, and I can't get you out of my mind. There is so much that I don't understand, but I know you're dancing with an angel.
I'm Jared, grandson of Roland. I have the best memories of him when my dad would drop me off really early before work. When my dad left, the first thing Grandpa would do is look over at me with a smile on his face and say, "Ready to get donuts?" We would jump in his truck and take off to Thriftway. I love you, Grandpa.
You had love for your family, love for all people, love for the father and son.
Hi everybody, I'm John Schock, and I just want to share a memory from when I was a kid about Grandpa Hauser. I remember when I was real small, the idea that I had two grandpas was a little confusing to me, that they had the same name, and I needed some way to tell them apart. So my other grandpa was Grandpa Herman, but Grandpa Hauser I called Big Grandpa, because Grandpa Hauser was very large in many ways. He was large in physical stature, very strong, very deep in voice, and he just had a very large presence. And I remember that I liked to crawl up in his little armchair and sit on his lap, and he always felt like a giant to me. And so Big Grandpa is always a large person in my mind, and I will remember him as having a big impact as well.
This is Josh, grandson of Roland. He was definitely a memorable figure to all. His light humor and genuine care for others made a mark on countless people. Recently, we visited his favorite restaurant, and even the waitress shared her memories of him, saying, "He was the guy who always teased me. He was a hard man to forget."
Dancing with the angels.
At the end of life, a man's worth is measured not by the money and things that he has accumulated, but rather by the family and friends that gather to reflect on and celebrate his life. Roland and Kay have been wealthy people, 6 wonderful children, and many grandchildren and great-grandchildren. They have a large extended family and many friends that are as close as family. They have always been generous and open with their home and shared their family with others. The time I spent with Roland helped me become a better person. While Sherry and I have spent most of the last 35 years living at great distance from Roland and Kay, we still felt close to them and always look forward to time spent together. I hope that I am as generous and gracious with others as Roland has been with me.